Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Tech with Nick. I'm your host Nicholas, and today I'm going to show you some of the most brilliant and awesome Raspberry Pi projects I have seen lately. I'll be covering projects for all skill levels, and I'll even show you a way to convert your Raspberry Pi into a drone. So be sure to watch the video to the end to find your next project. And as always, if you like what you see, please like and share this video so more people will see these amazing projects. Without further ado, let's get started. Just some quick info before we're diving into these amazing projects. I'll leave a link for each and every project in the description down below with a guide for you to build each and every one of those. So I'll just jump on the computer and show you the first project we're going to cover. All right guys, the first project we're going to cover is this white noise box. White noise and brown noise has been proven to give a better, more consistent sleep, but it either requires an expensive device or a subscription app on your phone. So what if you could use your Raspberry Pi for just that? This Pi project solves this. Alan Boris built a white noise box with an older Raspberry Pi and a few simple tools. He documented exactly how he built it in his step-by-step guide. So if you're anything like me, thinking about all the cool stuff you want to build when it's actually time to sleep, this white noise box might be both a fun project to build and could actually help you sleep even better. This next project is perfect if you work from home, if you just keep forgetting your plans for the day. The creator, Danny Onesco, I think it's pronounced, used an open source GitHub project to build an amazing workday progress bar that seamlessly integrates into any office. And by using a Raspberry Pi Pico and a LED light, he integrated his Google Calendar to make a progress bar of his day. And this easily shows meetings throughout the day in a simple but really elegant way. In my book, this is not only a highly practical use for Pico, it's solving a pretty huge problem for most people. I know at least for me, I have to look at the calendar multiple times a day to remember if I got any meetings. The next project is awesome. The creator of this project said, I wanted to recreate the experience of browsing through a physical album while still using modern technology. So with a simple Raspberry Pi Zero, an RFID reader, and some RFID chips, he built a Raspberry Pi Grammophone. This is pretty cool, and it utilizes the RFID chips, so each of them is built to play a different song or album. This way you can simply place the chip on the reader and the Pi will start playing your song using the Spotify API. This is built using a simple Python program, and this is one everyone should and could build. If you're liking this content, I would highly appreciate if you could give the video a like. It will tell the YouTube algorithm that this is a good video and more people should see these amazing projects. If you like tinkering and building cool stuff, please subscribe to the channel and ring the little bell notification in the corner. This allows me to make awesome videos about cool stuff for you. Thank you, and let's continue. The next project takes advantage of all the amazing opportunities in the AI space. Apple build a picture frame that generates images using stable diffusion. You'll need an e-ink screen to display your images. He even built a dashboard in the project so you can request new pictures of anything you could dream about. And the Pi will generate it using the prompt and display it directly in the frame. No more boring frames with the same pictures. You can create and show whatever you think of. Built with Python and a Docker image, this is simple to run and simple to deploy. The next project is perfect for you if you hate getting up to see who's at the door and don't feel like paying a subscription service to access a video feed. This project will solve that. In this project, you'll build a video doorbell using a Raspberry Pi with two-way audio and push notifications. All you need is a Raspberry Pi, a camera, and a microphone. No more getting up to see who's at the door. Instead, you'll just get a notification on your phone. And if you like to push the limit, you could even build a face recognition software into it, so it not only knows if someone is at the door, but you know exactly who it is. The next project will solve one of the biggest issues ever: spotty Wi-Fi. Let's be honest, spotty Wi-Fi sucks. And in this project, you're going to build a Wi-Fi extender using a Raspberry Pi and a Wi-Fi adapter. A simple but effective project to combat bad Wi-Fi, and because of the size of it, it's easy to pack and use on your next holiday or trip, so you'll always have good Wi-Fi from now on. This next project is a fun way of saving money and monitoring your language. With this amazing project, you'll get a reminder every time you swear, and the noise won't stop before you put in a coin. A funny project if you or someone in the family swears a bit too much. Using this, everybody in the house will know someone sweared, and you can even save some spare change and spend on the next amazing gadget. In the next project, all you need is an e-ink screen and a Pi. And with this, you can build an always up-to-date weather station. to show you the data you care about. And using the E-ink screen means this is using a very small amount of power. And even if the power dies, the image stays on. This fits perfectly in every household with its simplistic design, and it gives you a chance to build something cool and really useful. This next one will have you flying. It's a Raspberry Pi Zero turned into a drone. And if you're interested in drones and want to build your own, this is an epic project doing just that. You need a few tools, but the total cost of the project is less than 200 bucks. And you will have an epic gadget to play with after this. Last but not least, are you tired of ads? Of course you are. Who isn't? So why not block them all from your network using a Raspberry Pi and Pi hole? And I'll teach you exactly how to do that in this video right here, which you can watch next.